Hello friend, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering question number 201 to 220. These questions are belong to a part 9 of top 300 MCQ of Evidence Act 1872. Now starting here, question number 201. The privilege in respect of husband, wife under section 122 of Evidence Act relates to the question which the witness cannot be compelled to answer, the question which a witness cannot be permitted to answer, both A and B, only B, not A. So here the witness cannot be compelled, first important thing here, cannot be compelled to give the answer, and witness cannot be permitted to give the answer. So both options are correct here. So option C is correct here, option A and B. Question number 202, admissibility of the evidence under section 122 of Evidence Act has to be adjudged in the light of the status on the date when the communication was made, in the light of status on the date when the communication is sought to be tendered in court, in the light of status on the date when the evidence to be given in the court, either A or B or C. So here question section 122, so 122 provided that the communication during marriage. So communication during marriage, in the light of status on the date when the communication was made. So the admissibility of evidence under section 122 of Evidence Act has to be adjudged in the light of the status on the date when the communication was made. So here answer is option A. Question number 203. The communication made to the spouse during the marriage. Yes, it is belong to section 122 of Evidence Act. Remain privileged communication after dissolution of marriage by divorce or death. Does not remain privileged after the dissolution of marriage by divorce or death. Here does not. Here is assertive sentence, option A. Option C, does not remain privileged after the dissolution of marriage by divorce but remain privileged even after death. Option D, remain privileged after the dissolution of marriage by divorce but not so on after death. So in this question it is option A is here correct. The privilege remain privileged communication after dissolution of marriage by divorce or death, both option here, both points are correct here, both are very. So the communication made to the spouse during the marriage is getting the benefits of the communication during the dissolution. It may be getting the privilege after the dissolution, after the dissolution of marriage of die by divorce or death. So option A is correct here. Question number 204. The document containing the communication from husband to wife or vice versa in the hand of the third person is not admissible in evidence until the consent to by the writer of the communication is not admissible in evidence at all. Is admissible in evidence, either A or B. So here answer is option C is correct. Is admissible in evidence. A document containing the communication from husband to wife or from wife to husband in the hand of a third person is admissible in evidence. Question number 205. The husband or wife are permitted to disclose any communication between them during marriage in civil proceeding, between the party in criminal proceeding. First option civil, second one criminal proceeding between the party, matrimonial proceeding between the parties, all of the above. So here option D is correct. Here all of the above. The husband and wife are permitted to disclose any communication between them during marriage in civil, in criminal, in matrimonial. So option D is correct here. Question number 206. The protection under section 122 of Evidence Act available to witness, husband and wife, as a witness, both A and B, either A or B. So here answer is option B is correct, because the section 122 provide that the communication during marriage, so marriage is always held between husband and wife, man and woman. So option B is correct. Question number 207. The protection under 122 of Evidence Act confined to confidential communication and not applicable to a general communication between husband and wife, not confined to confidential communication only, but extend to a communication of whatever nature, confined to confidential communication and may be extended to communication of general nature, only C and not A or B. So in this question option B is correct here. Not confined to confidential communication only, but extend to a communication of whatever nature. Question number 208. The protection under section 122 of Evidence Act can be waived by a witness without the consent of the husband or wife, can be waived by a witness with the consent of husband or wife only, cannot be waived by the witness under any circumstance. Option D here, either A or C. So in this question the answer option A is correct here. Can be waived by a witness without the consent of husband or wife. Question number 209. The communication in respect of the affair of the state are privileged communication on the ground of public policy. Under public policy, yes, here important word, public policy. Under section 123 of Evidence Act, under section 124 of Evidence Act, under section 125 of Evidence Act, under section 126 of Evidence Act. So here answer is under section 123 of Evidence Act. So 126 of Evidence Act provided that the evidence as to affair of state and it is follow the rule of the feeling of public welfare is the best law. It follow the rule of feeling of public welfare. Welfare is the best law. Question number 210. The document in respect of which the privilege has been provided under section 123 of Evidence Act is published official record, is an unpublished official record, both A and B, either A or B. So in this question answer is here B, is an unpublished official record. Question number 211. in deciding whether the document fall in the category of unpublished official record. The court, option A here, has the jurisdiction to inspect the documents itself. The court has the jurisdiction to inspect document itself. The court is banned from inspecting the document. The court can compel the production of a document for inspection. Option D, both A and C are correct. So in this question, option B is correct here. The court is banned from inspecting the document. Question number 212. Section 124 of Evidence Act provides for privilege in respect of professional communication, official communication, communication as information of commission of offense, and none of the above. So section 124 of Evidence Act provided that official communication. Question number 213. For a protection under section 124 of Evidence Act, the communication is to be made to a public officer in official confidence, public officer as to routine time matter, public officer as an ordinary cause of his duties, either A or B or C. So in this question, answer is here, option A is correct, public officer in official confidence. Question number 214. The professional privilege under section 126 of Evidence Act is available in respect of communication made for the purpose of professional employment, in the cause of employment, both A and B, neither A nor B. So in this question, the both statements are true here. For the purpose of professional employment and cause of employment. So option C is correct. Question number 215. The legal advisor can disclose the communication after his client death, can disclose the communication after the relation with his client has ended, cannot disclose the communication even when the relation is ended or client has died. Both A and B are correct here. So in this question, option C is correct. The legal advisor cannot disclose the communication even when the relation is ended or the client has died. The both condition, when the relation means here the relationship between the legal advisor and the client has been ended or the client has been dead, in both conditions the legal advisor has not a power to disclose the communication during their relation. Question number 216. The protection under section 126 of Evidence Act extend to the communication made in furtherance of any illegal design, any fact observed showing the communication of any offense or fraud committed since a commencement of employment, both A and B, neither A nor B. In this question, option D is correct, neither A nor B. So the protection under 126, the 126 section provided that the professional communication has not protected in illegal design and in fraud or any offense. In these conditions, the protection to professional communication is not provided. So option D is correct here. Question number 217. An accomplice is an competent witness under section 118 of Evidence Act, under section 119 of Evidence Act, under section 133 of Evidence Act, and under section 132 of Evidence Act. So here answer is under section 133 of Evidence Act. The definition of accomplice provided and under section 133 of Evidence Act. In this section, provided that the accomplice shall be a competent witness. It does not provide the definition of accomplice. It provides the compatibility of a competitiveness of evidently power, evidential value of the accomplice. It provides that the accomplice shall be a competent witness against accused person. And if the conviction is not illegal, mere the uncorroborative testimony of the accomplice. Question number 218. An accomplice is a person who participates in the commission of the crime for which the accused has been charged, and who is prefended in the confederate, and who is an informer. All of the above, both A and B. So here option A is clearly here answer. The person who participate in commission of crime. So prefriended, confederate is not here, and informer also not here. The accomplice is a person who participate in the commission of crime and ready to give the evidence against their other participants of the crime. Question number 219. The testimony of an accomplice before it accepted and acted upon must be corroborated from a testimony of another accomplice, must be corroborated from an independent source, need not be corroborated at all, either A or C. So here answer is must be, option C. B is correct here, must be corroborated from independent source. It is clear here, whenever the judge or magistrate taking the judgment on the basis of the testimony of uncorroborated testimony of accomplice, he should be taking the corroboration to the other evidence, other independent evidence. And this section 133 must read with section 114 B. Now we are coming to the question number 220, the final question of this video. The question as to admissibility of evidence that should be decided as they rises should be reversed until judgment, reserve until judgment may be decided as they arise, or may be reserved until judgment. Option D, either B or C. So here answer is option A is correct, should be decided as they arise. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you.